Our guest today was recently recognized as a Digital Leader of the Year for leading the push in financial technology in the country.
Let's talk about the importance of embracing fintech and how businesses can reap its benefits. Joining us now, Fintech Alliance PH founding chairman Lito Villanueva. He's also the executive vice president of RCBC, where he played a key role in accelerating the bank's digital transformation. Thank you very much for joining us.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you, Ron.
Rainy, stormy Monday. Right? So, Lito, you've been in the banking industry for quite some time already. We won't say how long.
Divulging the age.
How much is in percentage? How much is the bank's spending for technology now? Maybe in the industry as a whole, and do you think that's going to grow in the next years?
You know, Salve, on the average, it would be between 10 to 15% in terms of budget when it comes to supporting digitalization in any organization, especially in the fintech or in the banking industry. And I think we've seen the exponential growth of digitalization, especially at the height of the pandemic.
Right.
And we're seeing the fruits of those initiatives, and we've seen the growth trajectory, you know, the growth momentum of adoption of consumers when it comes to digital payments.
Mm-hmm. How big has the jump been, of businesses, most especially banks, going into fintech, and how much of the population is already benefiting from it?
You know, the good news is that even the BSP has been very supportive of the whole idea of really pushing for digitalization. In fact, we are very confident that the BSP's goal of what they call the Digital Payments Transformation Roadmap would be fulfilled or will be achieved by end of this year.
This year.
That would be 50% of retail financial transactions to be in the form of digital, and onboarding at least 70% of adult Filipinos to the formal financial system. So, and the good news is that we will be able to fulfill those twin goals by end of this year.
And it was precisely due to technology, right? Because if we were going to wait for all of the branches to reach all of the, how many barangays in the Philippines do
it's
not
about,
have
yeah, 42,000 barangays.
Exactly. And there's some that still do not have bank branches, but because of fintech, right?
And practically
wallets,
making use of your smartphones as your, you know, banking service device, right? Mm-hmm. So that's really you being able to have access to all these financial services. And one thing in the Philippines is that having to have that access to finance has always been the major concern, right? Or the major push of government, and of course also by the private sector.
It's not without challenges, but do tell us, what are the current and possible foreseeable roadblocks in the near future that could hamper the growth?
You know, Ron, having over 7,100 islands in the Philippines, the digital infrastructure remains to be a major concern, right? Mm. So while we are trying to promote inclusive digital finance, of course we all know that connectivity is a primary consideration. Yeah. You're not just talking of access to data, you're also talking of affordability. Right? Because remember, Philippines is one of the countries in the ASEAN region or in the Asia-Pacific region that has practically one of the most expensive when it comes to data access. So I think having to provide that inclusivity amongst Filipinos, aside from providing, you know, financial services, you also need to provide affordable and reliable data access.
You were in the tech, connectivity field. How do you call that? In the telco industry
for over five years.
What's your sense of how these developments are going? Are we going fast? Are we going fast enough? Should we go faster?
I think we're going fast enough. We've seen additional telco player, right? And we've also seen other independent telco players, such as foreign
SpaceX.
Yeah. Yes, in the spaces, right? So, and again, leveraging on technology, and again, at the end of the day, it's really more affordability, more reliability in terms of connectivity, mm-hmm. and the very essence of financial inclusion is really having to provide those services at the grassroots level, right? So making sure that everyone in Juana de la Cruz would have that, would be able to enjoy those benefits, right? Again, during the son of the president, one of the things that he made mention of was really digitalization being his main agenda in his administration, right? So that's why the digital or the fintech industry has been supporting that advocacy, especially on having to push for the immediate passage of the open access mm-hmm. bill, right? So having to allow all internet service providers to be able to to provide those services even to all the 42,000 barangays mm-hmm. nationwide.
You mentioned it twice already, and every time you talk to someone from the bank, financial inclusion is always going to be mentioned. But how do you actually measure your success? How do you gauge your success in including everyone in financial inclusion? Let's say just for your bank, for RCBC.
For RCBC, it doesn't start and end with just having to onboard Filipinos or for them to have access to financial services in terms of having to open a basic deposit account mm. or any bank account for that matter. It's really more about the challenge of how they could sustain usage or be able to be wherein this financial services could now through the use of smartphones, for example, or mobile apps, could now be part of their everyday lives, right? So it's really more because activation or acquisition of customers, onboarding them is one story, but it will be a different story altogether if you're talking of sustaining them to make use of those facilities, and how these facilities or platforms will be able to change their lives or make that high impact when it comes to improving their livelihood, for example, mm. or their household incomes, et cetera. So
you're not talking about convenience only. You're actually talking about if you want to make a super app, for example, that actually makes a small entrepreneur able to access more borrowing so that they can grow their business. That's what you're talking about.
Yes, because remember we have quite a number of new to credit individuals, mm. because one of the things that we're also trying to address is on how we can divert those Filipino entrepreneurs to formal credit, because most of them would be victims of illegal
fraud.
Lenders or predatory lenders, mm. right? So that's why we're trying our best to really provide that education, that financial literacy on how they could be able to help themselves build right. their own small businesses, and how these private sector companies, for example, or even fintechs would now be able to provide that guidance and provide that financial services.
With different industry, different establishments and institutions ramping up their use of fintech for the benefit, of course, of the customers, it's a win for them. But when you talk about businesses, if every one of the institutions have the same thing, same technology, how can one get an edge over the other?
Yeah, for example, in RCBC, we have been, our advocacy has been innovations with empathy. It doesn't start and end with you having to develop the sexiest mobile app or the most robust platform, for example. I think the critical component is how you really address the pain points of your consumer mm. and be able to tell a story and for them to be able to navigate that experience by themselves, right? So it's really more on how you can really tell a sorbetero or magtataho or any ambulant vendor on the banking terminologies that would be further simplified by practically converting that or translating those terminologies into Filipino or Tagalog. For example, we came up with RCBC Discartech, which is the first of its kind in the world with multilingual mobile app, making use of banking terminologies in Taglish and now in Cebuano, Because again, one of the barriers to entry is again language, right? Yeah. Because you don't expect Filipinos to be knowledgeable about interest rates.
Exactly,
or investments.
A lot of them get intimidated by
precisely.
This,
yeah. So you need, again, part of the experience must be again education.
Well, I just realized that if I'm a CEO thinking about how to spend my 10% to 15%. And should I just make a Filipino app? Or where would I put my budget if I want to be good in the technology side of my business?
You know, going digital is not all about having to put the word digital in your press releases, your products or services. Because going digital is all about culture, all about mindset, all about having to have that experience across, you know, across the market that you are trying to serve, right? But I think to your question, I mean, how, for example, how can an entrepreneur be able to, you know, set aside, you know, X amount of money for him or her to save? Definitely, part of that is again education, right? Because we have quite a number of instances where, you know, cases like, you know, a cyber fraud or you know, people who are, you know, victimized by lots of scams, right? Again, you really have to make sure that you also educate them along the way, and not to be not to be susceptible to all of these you know, scams. Right?
Yeah,
and dami nun.
Yeah, but if I were going to use your 10% to 15% of RCBC's total budget for innovation or technology, do I spend more of that money in cybersecurity? Do I spend more of it in developing platforms or communities? Where is it best to invest?
You know, banks, fintechs, all organizations in the financial services would definitely invest heavily on cybersecurity. Because if there's one commodity that financial services or financial companies would provide their customers, that would be trust, right? And trust is, you know, your sacred promise or sacred commitment to your customers. That's why you are investing heavily on protecting your organization, the customers, and of course on cybersecurity, and of course with education on technology, and having to really provide that, you know, delightful customer experience with utmost customer consumer protection. So that's why I think for RCBC, I mean, you just reported a while ago about that investment of
27 billion.
The 27 billion from SMBC. That will this is another exciting story for RCBC. Exciting times ahead, because we would be able to make use of that for quite a number of initiatives, especially on expanding our loan portfolio, to further digitalize our services, and a lot of things that would be happening along the way.
If you didn't get the hit, that was the point of the question.
Innovation budget, the innovation budget that Lito will be having. Can I ask one more question, Ron? So you have Pulse?
Yeah.
And we haven't even talked about FinTech Alliance, because I know that you also have something on cybersecurity with FinTech Alliance. So quick question on the two of them, Pulse and then cybersecurity.
Yes, starting August 8th, the public will now be able to download the RCBC Pulse. That's the RCBC is now leveling up the digital banking experience, so you'll be able to experience another level of digital banking in the Philippines with RCBC Pals. And of course, we also have RCBC Discartech for the mass market, and we also have the RCBC ATM Go. That is actually the country's first countryside ATM that accepts all BankNet ATM prepaid or debit cards, no? So, and again, at the end of the day, it's really more about having to service everyone in Juana de la Cruz in the country.
And for FinTech Alliance, there's an event coming in, happening 7th and 8th.
August 7th and 8th, there will be our third Index Summit, that is the Inclusion and Digital Transformation Summit, happening at Shangri-La Fort. With
you got everybody in there.
Yes, practically everyone, all the VIPs, all the shakers and movers in the industry will be there, and I hope all our friends from the fintech industry, from you know, of course, even from the government and the private sector, would be able to join us on 7 and 8. And of course, we will be having our second year of our Ambassadors Gala because remember, even the foreign missions would be partners of the FinTech Alliance. And we will also be launching or making public the 2023 Philippines FinTech Report.
Wow. Well, we're very grateful that you can speak 100 words per minute. Thank you so much for talking to us today. Thank you.
Pleasure.
Lita, thanks. Thank you.